I'm very proud of the fact the Benazir Income Support Program has been providing a blind lifeline to millions of vulnerable women across the country, offering them financial assistance and social protection while giving many women the incentives and seed capital to start up small businesses. I'm glad that the number of the beneficiaries of the poverty alleviation program has risen to over 9 million, but we need to bring more underprivileged women into the social safety net. I am hopeful that the new government will actively work to reduce social and economic fragility while aggressively promoting girls' education and health, including programs to reduce maternal mortality and enhance mother and child income. Mr. Speaker, you are aware the menace of terrorism is again rearing its ugly head and is threatening our nation's security as well as regional peace and prosperity. Pakistan believes that terrorism is a shared concern that requires collective efforts. We expect neighboring countries to take strong notice of terrorist groups who are involved in launching attacks against our security forces and people. Today, I reaffirm the nation's resolve to eliminate terrorist elements. My late wife, the twice elected Prime Minister of Pakistan, Mohtarma Benazir Bhutto Shaheed, gave her life standing up to terrorists, so you will never find me wanting in building the unity and the momentum behind such an effort. We are proud of our armed forces, law enforcement agencies who have rendered immense sacrifice and played a heroic role in the fight against terrorism, defense of our national frontiers. I would also like to take this opportunity to thank our friendly countries, particularly Saudi Arabia, UAE, China, Turkey, and Qatar, who have always supported Pakistan in difficult times. It is important also to recognize the US, EU, and UK have all been established trade partners with a history of cooperation in many sectors, which we hope will grow further. I extend my heartfelt gratitude to China for its unwavering support to Pakistan in various fields and enduring strategic all-weather friendship between Pakistan and China is a cornerstone of stability in the region. We remain steadfast in our commitment to collaborate with China to advance our shared goals and fostering regional peace, promoting connectivity, ensuring prosperity, and maintaining stability, which includes completion of the China-Pakistan Economic Corridor. We will not allow hostile elements to jeopardize this vital project or undermine the strong bond between our two nations. We will take all necessary measures to ensure the security of our Chinese brethren and sisters. Before I conclude, I must remind the world of the unsung sacrifices of our Kashmiri brethren, their ongoing struggle for the freedom of Indian illegally occupied Jammu and Kashmir, the revocation of Article 370 and 35A is part of India's strategy to reduce Kashmiris Muslims to a minority in our own homeland. Pakistan rejects the one-sided India action and calls upon India to reverse all illegal measures taken on our on or after 5th of August 2019. I assure our Kashmiri brothers and sisters that Pakistan will continue to provide moral, political, diplomatic support to the people of occupied Kashmir until they get the right to self-determination. Pakistan believes that the key to durable peace in South Asia is the resolution of dispute in accordance with the United Nations Security Council resolution. Similarly, we are deeply concerned over the tidal wave of indiscriminate killings of innocent Palestinians and large-scale genocide committed by the Israeli forces. Pakistan strongly condemns the brutality and inhumanity of occupation forces and remains steadfast in principled support for the establishment of an independent and viable state of Palestine based on the pre-96 borders of Quds al-Sharif as its capital. Mr. Speaker, honorable parliamentarians, I have complete faith in the capability of our political leadership, public institutions, civil society and youth to successfully overcome the multiple challenges facing our nation today. This is based on my unshakable belief in the citizens of people, knowing that whenever we unite to make common cause, we deliver on our promises. Today too, I believe we can pull together to draw on our moral political capital in steering our country out of its complex but not impossible social, climate and economic challenges. Once again, let me entreat you all to think of this great country as your driving motivation for service in this House of Parliament. Let us demonstrate a spirit and words, a renowned political ethos, a collaboration and census building as the guiding principle to lay the groundwork for a more prosperous Pakistan. I am certain that together, in a fresh start, we can start a course towards a strong, prosperous Pakistan. May Allah be our guide and support this journey. Ameen. Pakistan, Paindabad.
Thank you, Mr. President. In exercise of powers conferred by Clause 1 of Article 54 of the Constitution of the Islamic Republic of Pakistan, I hereby prorogue the session of both houses summoned to assemble together on Thursday, 18th April 2024, on conclusion of this business signed by the President of Pakistan.